Good morning, VKids. It's great to have you join with us again today. Good morning to you, Hamilton. How are you doing? Are you good? Good. And everyone, give us a wave if you're at home, watching at home. And if you're all watching at church with us all, give us a wave as well. It's so great to have everyone join with us today. And we're learning all about how we were made to be in God's family. So I'm so excited to learn all about that. Are you excited, Hamilton? Yes, should we get started? Yes, so first of all, let's go and say hello to Amanda for our joke of the week. Hi, Amanda.
Hi, VKids. It's Amanda with your joke of the week. Why did the birdie go to the hospital? Anybody know? I do, because he needed a tweetment.
Granny Paige Turner here. I'm just at my synchronized swimming rehearsal because now it's the summer and I don't want to be indoors all day, so I'm learning synchronized swimming. It's really a lot of fun. Now, do you remember last week we learned all about how we were made to worship God? You do? Well, this week we're learning all about how we belong in God's family, and we're going to be watching a story all about how we can be fishers of people. Now that sounds very strange, doesn't it? I know we can fish, but I didn't realise we can fish for people. So let's all watch the story together now.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus calls Peter. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus grew up in Nazareth.
Hey, Jesus.
And was baptized by John in the Jordan River. Jesus began teaching about God's love and healing people of their sickness. One day, John saw Jesus walking by and told the people around him that Jesus was the Lamb of God. One of the people standing with him was Andrew, whose brother was Simon, who would later be known as Peter. Andrew went to find his brother and said, "We have found the Christ."
"Whoa, really? Come on."
Simon went with Andrew and met Jesus.
I'm Simon.
Jesus looked at Simon and said, "Your name is Simon, son of John."
"Yes, it is."
"But you will be called Peter."
Okay.
On another day, Jesus was walking along the shore of the Sea of Galilee, and lots of people crowded around him to hear what he had to say.
Hello. Okay.
Jesus noticed two empty boats, for Andrew and Peter had left them and were washing their nets. Jesus stepped into one of the boats.
"Hey, Peter."
And asked Peter to take him out into the sea.
"Aye, aye."
So he sat in the boat and taught the crowds from there. When he had finished speaking, he said to Peter, "Now go out where it is deeper and let down your nets to catch some fish." But Peter said, "We worked hard all last night and didn't catch a thing. But if you say so, I'll let the nets down again." And this time, their nets were so full of fish, they began to tear.
"Whoa!"
They called to some other fishermen for help.
"Hey, help!"
And soon both boats were filled with fish. When Peter realized what happened, he fell to his knees before Jesus and said, "Oh Lord, please leave me. I'm such a sinful man." Jesus replied to Peter, "Don't be afraid. Come, follow me, and I will show you how to fish for people."
"Really?
Really?"
And as soon as they landed, they left their nets and followed Jesus. So Simon Peter became one of Jesus' 12 disciples and followed his friend Jesus throughout his time on earth.
Allison, did you enjoy that story about how Jesus called Peter and then he told them all about how to fish for people? You did? Yes, so did I. And now we're going to find out a bit more about how that fits into our theme of today, which was, can you remember? Yes, it was how we were made to belong in God's family. But to tell us a bit more about that, I think we're going over to France to see Mademoiselle Patisserie Le Croissant. So let's say hello to her now. Bonjour, mon petit pois, Mademoiselle Patisserie Le Croissant here. And I much really enjoyed that story about how we can become fishers of people. And you know how Jesus called Peter, who was a fisherman. He wasn't this spectacular, rich, clever person. He was just a normal person. And you know he was welcomed into God's family. Just as we are welcomed into God's family, we can be followers of Jesus. And you know that reminds me of a recipe to do with you now. If only I had my assistant, Mimi. Mimi! Mimi? Are you there, Mimi? Where is she there? Mimi? Oh! Mimi! There she is! Hello! It's so nice to have my assistant to chat with and help me with the recipe. Okay, so Mimi, we're going to be making some gingerbread people to remind us we are all in God's family together. So, let's all start with, may we have the flour please, Mimi? We're going to start with some flour. That's the flour right there. Thank you so much. Thank you. And then we just very carefully, you know how I like to be so careful, we're going to put the flour in. There we go. There we go. The flour. Perfecto. Okay, Mimi, may we next please have the eggs? Thank you. We have the eggs. Thank you, Mimi. Perfect. So we're going to be mixing up the eggs with the flour. Thank you, Mimi. Thank you so much. So delicate. Thank you very much. And then obviously we put the eggs in. Okay. Oh, there it goes. So we have one egg. I think we need the other egg, please, Mimi. Thank you so much. Thank you. Yes, I take that from you. Two eggs. Oh dear. There it goes. There we have the eggs. All right. So the next thing we need, Mimi, we need the sugar. Do we have some sugar over there? We have the sugar. Perfect. Just a little bit of sugar to make it a little bit sweet. Okay. Okay. Just a little bit of the sugar in there. Perfect. Okay. And you can see I stir it all up. But we need to make it into a nice dough. So you know what we need, Mimi? We need some milk. Do we have some milk? Lovely. We have some milk. Thank you so much. You did that so well. Thank you. Okay. Okay. There's some milk in there. And then we just mix it all together. But you know what, VKids? And you know what, Mimi? We're making gingerbread people. So I think we need to put some clothes in there for the people. Don't you think? So they got some nice clothes. Should we add some clothes into the mixture? What do we have there, Mimi? Some nice clothes? Some sunglasses. Very important in the sunny weather. Yes, put them in. What else do we have? Some nice hair. Beautiful. Yes, put that in. Mix it all together. Yes, that's lovely. Oh, lovely accessories. We love the accessories. Okay, a beautiful frock. Okay, do we have a nice hat? Oh, we love to have a hat, don't we, Mimi? We love hats. Pop that in. Okay, mix it all together. And you know, in our story, like I was saying, we know we all belong in God's family, whoever we are. We might not think we're perfect. We might not think we deserve it. But we do. God made us in His image, you know? So we might feel like we look a little bit like a mess like this, but you know, God made us in His image. So, now I'm going to put this on the tray. We have the head, the body. Okay, the head, the body, and the legs. Don't forget the legs. There we go. The heads and the body and the legs. You know, it looks a bit of a mess, but sometimes we might feel like we're a bit of a mess, and maybe we don't think we belong in God's family, but we do. All right, so. We now put this in the oven. Okay, so put this in the oven. And then, let's see how it turns out. Et voila! You know, we are all part of God's family. He made us in His image, and He calls us to be in His family. Isn't that such good news, Mimi? Yes, maybe you can make this at home. Okay, until next time, au revoir, mon petit pois. Well, didn't you think that making those gingerbread people looked really fun, but a little bit messy as well? Well, now it's time to go over to Hamilton's house to find out what our memory verse is for today. Are you there, Hamilton? Hello, VKids. It's memory verse time. And today the verse is from Galatians 3, verse 26. And it says, "In Christ Jesus, you are all children of God." Because remember, today we're learning all about how we belong in God's family. So you have great fun learning that at home or at church if you're in person, VKids. And I'll see you very soon. Bye! Hamilton, it's time for one of my favourite parts of the morning. It's worship time. But yes, first of all, we need to go over to Jenny in Australia for our worship warm-up. So hello to you, Jenny.
Hey guys, Jenny Jogslot here, just out in Melbourne, Australia, but super inspired by GPT and her synchronized swimming. Now, it's getting into actually winter here, so I'm wondering about taking up ice skating instead, maybe. Maybe let me know what you might think about that. Now, we're going to be doing our worship in a moment. We're going to be doing our new song, God Is With Us, where we have our big punch in the air. Can I see you all punching the air? Yes, amazing, you guys. All right, so we're going to do our warm-up first, and today, we've not done this for a long time, we're going to do our 10 jumping jacks. So, are you ready? If you're at home, standing up. If you're at church with us all, let's all stand up together. We're going to do our 10 jumping jacks. Here we go. And I want to hear you doing your countdown as well. All right. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Amazing job, you guys. Let's all worship together.
All right. Here we go. Even in the stormy weather, when it seems too tough, I will not be afraid. I will not be afraid. Even when the dark surrounds me and when things get rough, I will look to the Lord, I will look to the Lord. There's a promise He has made. It's not a promise He will break. God is with us, God is with us. He will never leave.
Well, I had so much fun being with you all this morning and worshipping with you and learning all about how we were made to be in God's family. And if you guys make any gingerbread people at home, do send your pictures to us at vkids@vintagechurchla.com so that we can see how those turned out as well. But until next week, we will see you very soon. Bye! We'll be right back.